All right, guys, Unfazed Gaming back again with another GTA Online glitch video. And in this video, I'm basically going to be showing you how to hit the outfit transfer glitch every time. Now, if you're wondering which outfit transfer glitch I'm talking about, it is the creator glitch, which goes from character 2 to character 1. Unfortunately, the one that we had with director mode that went from character 1 to character 2 is unfortunately now patched. So this is the original one that we've had for quite some months now, the creator method. However, Rockstar did patch a couple of things about it, so there's a lot of people recently not being able to hit this glitch. So what I'm going to show you in this video is how to hit it every single time, and hopefully you won't have any more problems with it. So before we start this video, I just want to say, if you are doing this glitch, it does involve deleting your second character. So if you don't want to delete your second character, obviously this glitch is not for you. It will also mean, just the same as any other transfer glitch, that you will lose all your outfits on your main character. I say just the same as every transfer glitch, because every transfer glitch works the same way, and that's you're completely replacing a full list of outfits from one character to the other. So if you've got no outfits saved at all on your second character and you do a transfer glitch, it will wipe all your outfits out. So unfortunately, that is just the way transfer glitches work. But in this situation, obviously, you can make some brilliant outfits using the transfer glitch. You can even set up outfits with merge components and stuff like that on, and then obviously add components from director mode or wherever else you want to get your joggers from and stuff like that. That's fine, you can do that, but as I say, it will delete all your outfits. So just a bit of a pre-warning there before anybody starts doing this glitch. Anyway, to start off with, I've heard a lot of rumours, people saying it doesn't work if your character 2 is already created. So I'm going to prove to you in this video that that's a myth, because I've done it loads of times. I've been backwards and forwards to my second character, just perfecting outfits before I've done the transfer, and then once I'm happy with them all, I've been transferring them all over. So you definitely do not need to create a new character every time you do this glitch. However, there is one very important part of this glitch. You do need to start off on your main character. So for example, if you load straight into character 2 and then try and do the transfer, it will not transfer. You'll be deleting your character for no reason whatsoever. You must load in as character 1 first, and then swap character to character 2, do the transfer glitch, and obviously go from there. If at any point during the transfer glitch you get kicked back to story mode, or you lose connection to GTA Online or anything like that, you must start from the beginning. So you must load up character 1 again and then swap character to character 2. That is a vital part of this glitch, and a lot of people miss that step out, and unfortunately that is stopping them transferring the outfits basically. So the second thing I want to get into is the race that you create. So when this glitch first came around, what we used to do is we used to start up the glitch, you know, go on to the second character, make the outfits, and then create the race. However, this is the part that's been patched. You can no longer create the race while you're doing the transfer. You can now only do it from a saved race. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to show you how to make the race, how to save it, and then obviously later on in the glitch, we're going to show you the transfer. So what you need to do is you need to go into Creator. And all you're going to do when you get to Creator is you're going to go to Creator Race, you're going to go down to Land Race, and it's pretty straightforward. You're doing basically the same as what we were doing before. So you're just going to place your trigger down somewhere. So as you can see, I'm just going to place my trigger. It doesn't really matter where you place it. I'm just putting mine on quite a long straight so that the race is easier to build. Wherever you want, it does not matter. So now the next step is to go to Race Details. And once you're in Race Details, you will need to add a title to be able to save it. Basically, you're just doing the bare minimum to be able to save this race. So you need to add a title, a description, and a photo. So you're just going to snap them wherever you want. It doesn't really matter. Now, your race type needs to stay as a standard race. The route type needs to be point to point. And I always change the maximum players to 2 because it's just easier to position the checkpoints and stuff. So at this point, you're going to go to placement. You're going to go to checkpoints, and you're just going to put a start line for the race. And all you need to do now is just place these checkpoints anywhere you want. You basically just got to make a straight line race that's longer than 0.65 miles. So as you'll see, I'm just going to drop all these down. Once we've got to point, well, ours is 0.7 miles, so we're just going to leave it at that. And once you've got your race built, all you're going to do is test it, and that will allow you to save it. So obviously, you're just going to run straight through the test, accept the alert to return to the creator, and then we're just going to save this race. Now, as I said before, this is exactly the same method that a lot of people have been doing anyway, because obviously a lot of people have still been doing this glitch and it's still been working for them. But the guys who've been creating the race during the transfer, that's the guys who have been failing quite a lot recently. So as I say, we're going to save this race now. Once you've saved the race, that is it. We're pretty much done. So at this point now, we're going to go back onto our main character. Now, if you have got an outfit you want to keep on your main character, make sure you're wearing it before you start the transfer. So this purple outfit, for example, I want to keep. So I'm going to wear this one. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go pause online. I'm going to go down to swap character and I'm going to select my second character. Now, this is not a new created character. This is a second character that already existed. So I'm going to show you that it does work. You do not need to create a new character each time. But basically, once you've got onto your second character, you're going to go and start building your outfits. Now, in this particular video, I'm not going to spend too long dwelling on the outfits. I'm going to go over these outfits in a separate video if you like the look of them. But yeah, I'm not going to go over them in this video. I'm just going to skip through this part. But basically, you want to build up your outfits on your female character that you're going to be transferring over. As soon as you've built all your outfits up, you're literally just going to hit pause and you're going to go creator. Now, once you get into creator, you're just going to go down to where it says load creation. So obviously you saved the race earlier on, so we're going to load that saved race. So it'll be in saved, it won't be in published because you don't actually need to publish it. So you're going to load the saved race. As soon as the race is loaded, all you're going to do is you're going to go straight down to test. Now you've just got to run straight through the test run, and as soon as you get the alert at the end of the test, you're just going to accept the alert and return back to the creator. Now, it is worth mentioning at this point, you don't really want to be pressing any other buttons. All you want to do is you want to accept the alert and wait for the creator to load back up. And then as soon as you load into creator, you'll be sat above the ground like this. You're going to hit pause. You're going to go across to online and you're going to go to choose character. Now, once you've pressed choose character, you're going to load back into the character selection screen. And obviously, you're going to have your two characters stood there. Now, normally, and this is where you've got to be pretty careful, you'll automatically be hovering over player one. So you'll have to be really careful and make sure you select the right player because you do not want to be deleting your main character. So what you're going to do is you're going to go across to your character two and you're just going to hit delete. And make sure it is your character two that holds up the board when you go across. You do not want to delete your main character. Anyway, as I say, you delete it. It makes you type in the word delete just to confirm that you're actually going to delete the character. And then it'll load you back into the character selection screen. Now, at this point, you don't want to be pressing anything. You want to let it just fully load up. And once the buttons come across the bottom like that, you're just going to hit B. Now, that'll take you back to story mode. Obviously, that's circle on PlayStation, I should mention. B on Xbox, circle on PlayStation, and it will just take you straight back to story mode. Now, as soon as you load into story mode, you're just going to hit pause. You're going to go across to online and you're going to start up an invite only session. And that is pretty much it, guys. That is the transfer complete. So as soon as you load in now to online, you'll load in as your main character and you will have all the outfits from your second character. So the main thing to do, remember, is save the current outfit that you're wearing because you will lose it because it's not in a saved slot at the moment. So I'm just going to go ahead and save this outfit, but you'll notice as soon as I bring up the saved outfits menu, all the outfits are there that I've just transferred over from my female character. So, yeah, guys, this is still fully working. I just thought I'd do this video just to show you how to hit it 100% of the time. The main things to note are that the saved race method is the only working method at the moment. You cannot build the race while you're doing the glitch, and it's vital to go to character one before you go across to character two and start building your outfits. Those are the only two major things about it. Obviously, I'm going to be running through showing you these outfits in a separate video, so don't worry about the outfits, what's going on in the background. I just wanted to show you, how this glitch is still working, and obviously the different things that you need to do in order to get it working. So that is it for this video, guys. If you've enjoyed it, remember to stick a like on it. If you found it useful and helpful, remember to stick a like on the video. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't done already. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.